University of Texas at Austin students are seeding the future at the Half-Pint Urban Prairie, just down the street from the iconic campus tower. A project of the student-led Campus Environmental Center, they broke ground in February 2019 to demonstrate the beauty and importance of the Blackland Prairie ecoregion.
The Campus Environmental Center, it's the oldest and largest environmental student org on UT campus. We kind of institutionalized recycling back in 2002 before UT had recycling. Our main goal as an organization is to start environmental projects. Most of them are started by students. We have a bunch of project team leads, like the project team leads, Jack and Mark of Half-Pint Urban Prairie. And then we have five other projects that are led by all by students.
When I was in high school, I took this class where you get to look at what different professions are and you interview with people just to learn about what they do. And so I interviewed with a lot of ecologists that live in the DFW area, because that's where I went to high school. And then I learned about Blackland Prairies. It's a kind of prairie which is essentially an ecosystem dominated by grasses that runs in a narrow strip that runs from around the Texas-Oklahoma border through Dallas, through Austin, and through San Antonio. And it's a mixed grass prairie which is in between tall grass and short grass. It's the ecosystem that's native to Dallas, but most people in Dallas have no idea what a Blackland Prairie is. So just learning about it, I learned about how over 99% of it's been destroyed due to agriculture and urbanization. So it was just something that I cared a lot about, and I wanted more people to know about Blackland Prairies, and I wanted to hopefully inspire some conservation movements for them.
Austin's an ecotone, so it's this really interesting spot. We're right along the Blackland Prairie and where the Edwards Plateau meet. And so it's in this mixing between these two ecoregions, you get a lot of really interesting things that occur. And we didn't feel like the environment on campus really reflected how unique Austin's environment was. In talking to Landscape Services, once we had this idea, it took us about a year to finally get a location. They're really excited about the prairie as a kind of pilot program for using more native plants in this kind of wilder sense. We're really fortunate to have funding from the Green Fund. And that's a really special program here at UT where $5 out of every student's tuition per semester goes towards this competitive grant program that students, staff, and faculty can apply for.
I've always been interested in environmentalism, which isn't really the same as environmental science, but it's in the same ballpark. Ever since I was little, I would hang out in the woods around my house, and I live in Edwards Plateau, so I live just west of here. And I would go and I would walk around with my friend, and we would look at trees, and I didn't know anything. What we would just play in the forest, and we get lost, and we'd be there all day long. And I think that love for nature is what personally drives me to pursue things like sustainability and environmental science. It's so important to make that connection between scientists and what they know and people, just normal, average, everyday people, and what they need as a community, as a country, as a state, at all the different levels.
Finally, the Half-Pint team found an open, sunny spot for the pocket prairie, an old planter bordering the Student Services building and the CEC office. To eradicate the overgrown rosemary and invasive nandinas, concept met reality in shovel-wielding, sweat labor, and clear ground triumph. The next challenge was the deep incline, quite unlike a prairie. UT's Landscape Services had the solution.
So we ended up installing a core log on the top and bottom to prevent a lot of the soil from dripping out, and then installing different berms along the middle of the prairie. And so the berm is just this supportive structure of dirt. It's a little mound that breaks up the flow of water from top to bottom. And so we really leaned into that and used that as an opportunity to showcase a lot of the different grasses that can grow in the Blackland Prairie. So we planted Texas bluegrass and prairie wild rye and some of the other grasses.
And then another benefit of just this being a native prairie restoration is that all of our native prairie plants have really deep root systems. So once this is established, the soil is going to be held really firmly in place and we won't have to worry about erosion.
The team worked closely with Matt O'Toole, Director of Ecological Research and Design at the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center, and Jim Kars, UT's Landscape Services Manager. Along with expertise on soil, design, irrigation, and plant selection, they provided starter plants.
Most of what we planted was from plugs, from little 4-inch pots, and that gave us such a head start.
Along with warm and cool season grasses, they planted perennials to attract pollinators.
Part of the reason we included pollinator plants is because we wanted to be certified wildlife habitat, so by providing that, we can provide habitat for pollinators. And then that also helps us work on our Bee Campus USA certification, which is something that's in the works right now. And then another thing is just that flowers, they look great and people know what they are. Like, we have a cone flower right over there, and that's a really distinguishable prairie plant. So by including all of these brightly colored flowering plants, we can increase our appeal to people that otherwise aren't as interested in prairies. And then we're also working on seeding down some fall wildflowers like goldenrod and things like that. And just so that way there can be something different every season and also something interesting every season.
Right now we're setting up our prairie to be planted for the spring, and we're making seed balls to do that today.
So what are seed balls? Seed balls are little pieces of wet clay that you then put prairie seeds in.
Today we got buffalo grass, this green species over here, and we also have blue grama.
As a neuroscience student, Pranav raises awareness on how green spaces also benefit physical and mental health and have been linked with lower rates of depression and anxiety. But as the students learned, seeding new perceptions takes time to root.
We have this responsibility to take care of this and make sure that people understand it when they see it so that they don't ask landscape services why lawnmower is broken. That's definitely something that they deal with a lot. When you let these native plants grow up, they're like, why is this thing 4 feet tall? What's the reason for that? Like, are y'all lazy? What's going on? And so trying to make sure that we can preempt those things by helping people understand, it's like, well, these are tall because it provides shelter for the different animals on campus. One of the most important lessons we learned in Half-Pint in working in this like very urban environment, and we were kind of forced to think critically about how we use space, both on campus and in our communities. Like, what is every single spot being used for, and who's using it, and who is it accessible for, and who has programming that's made for it, and keeping those considerations in mind as we think about the way our cities have to change over the next 100 years and how we have to react to the climate crisis to reorganize the way that we situate ourselves. And so thinking about the role that prairies can play in that, but also just like more mindful urban development.
And I think that students really do have a unique perspective on what's best for their campus. We have to be here for 4 years, and so I think that it's important that we make the most of it.